Hey, what's up? It's Comic95, the Savior. And for this video, I am going to talk about the 10 most common ignorant backhanded compliments that I've gotten in Japan. Do keep in mind, excuse my top, that I am talking to you from a triple experience, or quadruple if you will. I am a foreigner. I'm a foreign woman. I'm a black woman. I'm an American woman. And obviously there are things about me that are going to be different from you that is watching. Thus, some of these things may or may not apply to you, but that's okay, because it's about me. These are the 10 most common things that I get. The list can go on much longer, but I'm just gonna stop and keep it at 10. So, they are not listed in any particular order, just 10 random things that I constantly hear from Japanese people that are meant to be positive comments. They're not meant to be insulting at all. They're authentically supposed to make me feel happy and make me say, oh, thank you, really, you know, type thing like that. Which I will not lie, when I first came here, I was ignorant and I kind of did see it as a compliment. But now that I've been here longer and I'm using my brain more and I've gotten a little bit older, I realize how ignorant these things are. So, let's get to it. Number one, you're so beautiful because you're a mixed race. This is implying that if I were entirely black, that I would not be beautiful, which I'm still black. It doesn't matter what percentage of me is something else. I identify as black. I look like a black woman. If I commit a crime or if I die, they're going to say a black woman. They're not going to say a 25% this, a 10% that, 5% whatever. It's an insult. You're implying that black people cannot be beautiful or attractive without having features or the influence or whatever mixture of another outside race. That's an insult. Backhanded compliment. Number two, I speak good Japanese because I'm half Japanese or because I am mixed race, once again, implying that the only reason why I can do intelligent or smart things is because I am not entirely black. Thus, a black person or an African person is not capable of speaking more than one language. I would not be intelligent or capable of comprehending the complex language of Japanese if not for the fact that I have a Japanese parent. This comment is normally given after I do something simple, such as introducing myself, thanking someone, or ordering something in Japanese. The first thing that someone will say is, hafu, you know, ask a question like that. Same thing goes with talking to guys online. They will assume that I must be half Japanese because there's no way that they fell in love with a beautiful black woman. There's no way a black girl could be attractive, right? Number three, I act Japanese. This comment is almost always given after I show that I'm an empath or I show that I have feelings for other people, that I care about what they might think or say about something. And I overdo stuff, as well as being mannerable, quiet, assimilating. People that meet me for the first time normally expect me to be loud and obnoxious because I am not only an American, but I am a black woman. They think I'm gonna have this really loud, out there personality, and honestly, that's just not me. But they don't expect that. So one of the first things people say is, oh, you really think Japanese, or you really act Japanese, which is super, super funny, because to me, I see it as being an influence from my religion. I am a Christian. I was born and raised as one. And I was born as a Christian. You get what I mean? I was raised in a Christian family. And I am a Christian myself. I believe that Jesus Christ is Lord and He is God. And with that said and done, I try to do things the right way. Is my life perfect? Do I do everything as a Christian should? No, I do not. That is not what this video is about. But what they view me, what I think is me acting like a Christian, Japanese people are like, oh, you're so Japanese. But for me, it's like, well, no, I care about how other people feel about stuff because golden rule. I personally think that Japanese people act Christian. It never even crossed my mind that this is a Japanese trait, apparently. So because I'm not ignorant, obnoxious, loud, ghetto, ratchet, that means that I'm Japanese. This is implying that an American, or especially a black woman, is not capable of assimilating and following rules and being civilized and quiet. I have to be loud. I have to be ghetto. I have to have, you know, be ill-mannered, not have good manners. I couldn't possibly care about other people. Being an empath? Caring about what other people might think? How this might affect other people? No, never. Even my coworker, my assistant teacher, said, oh, you act very Japanese, because I was worried about how my student's parent might perceive a message. Number four, I like light-skinned black women. Well, obviously, I am a light-skinned girl. but I'm also a Black woman at the end of the day, and while in one part I might say, oh, this is such a nice compliment, you like me, but when you dig deeper under the surface, you're saying that you wouldn't like me if I had darker skin. My grandparents are dark skin, and what you just said is insulting to my siblings and my family, even though they hate my guts, but you get what I mean. You're implying that my race is not beautiful if they have dark skin. You're also implying that the only reason why I'm attractive is because my skin is not dark, which is an insult. It's a compliment above the surface, because yeah, I'm light skin, that's me. But at the same time, you're insulting me and my race. You're implying that beautiful Black people can only have light skin, and the only reason why I am one of those beautiful Black people is because I have this particular feature. That's not really a compliment. Piggybacking off of number 4, and I think was it number 1 or something? Number 5, I'm beautiful because I'm American. This is normally said after I ask someone to guess what country I'm from, which I do this now just for the fun of it, and people say, oh, where are you from? And I say, America, from the USA, I'm from Chicago. They instantly say, oh, that's why you're so beautiful. Now, one part of me was like, oh, okay, they're complimenting the people from my country. They're saying that they're attractive. But when I looked under the surface and I started to ask more questions, it really turned out that they were saying they know that I'm not African, I can't be from the Caribbean, because I am an attractive woman. And attractive Black women do not come from these countries. I must be from America, where the good-looking Black people come from, basically, because I have light skin and I appear to be polished and have money or whatever crosses their mind. Above the surface, it's a nice compliment. They're saying, oh, American women are beautiful, American Black girls are cute. But when you take a step back and think about it some more, it's like, okay, you're saying that I'm only attractive because I'm a Black American woman. But you wouldn't have that same comment if I said that I'm from Jamaica or I am from Nigeria or whatever. Then it would be like, oh, really? Okay. Like, you know what I mean? Like, I can't explain it. Again, it's a compliment in one sense, but if you really think about it, it's a backhanded compliment, and thus it's an insult and not so much of a good thing to say. Number 6, you're so strong. And believe it or not, you guys, this is actually something that I've gotten both from guys that I've dated as well as people that I've worked with that weren't even Japanese, but we're talking about the Japanese side of things. This is a common thing that people say about Black people. This comment was actually made by a boss of mine that said, oh, you're Black, so, people from your country, whatever. I forgot his exact words. He didn't say because I was Black, but he was implying that because I was Black, I must be strong and didn't need health insurance. What the fuck? But yes, I'm serious. I'm not joking, you guys. And it wasn't just me. This was also said to a coworker of mine. And on top of that, for the people that I've dated, I commonly get this from guys. And so at first I was thinking, are they implying this because I'm fat? Like, is that supposed to mean like I must be strong or whatever? But then when I looked at it more and started talking to people more, they believe that I'm the strong athletic individual, which I won't lie, I did play sports when I was in high school and junior high, which I know it falls into the stereotype, but I can't have hobbies because I'm Black or something. Anyway, they really believe that you are the strong being, that anything that you want to do dealing with athletics, anything dealing with health or whatever, like you're just some type of beast or whatever and everything, and that's just not true. But again, in one sense, oh, they're saying I'm strong, I'm not weak. It's a compliment. But really, it's not a compliment. It's a stereotype. It's an insult. And I don't have some sort of superhuman steroid trait or gene because I'm a Black person. That's not the way that it works. I need health insurance just as much as you do. And I'm not super strong because I'm Black. I need to go to the gym just like how you do. Number 7, I wish I was mixed race like you, or I wish I was Black like you so I could be a professional athlete. I don't even know where to start with this, guys. Piggybacking off of the same thing that I just said, there is no special gene or trait. I know it's a stereotype and kind of a good one at that. It seems like Black people have some sort of like super gene where they're naturally good at sports, but that's a stereotype. That's the same thing as me saying, oh, I wish my kids were Asian so that they would get good grades and go to Harvard, etc. You have to study and work hard and train just like how anyone else does in order to get good grades, go to a good school. Some people are naturals at it. I would say I did pretty good in school, but same thing goes for sports. You have to work hard at it and train and try your best in order to do good at sports. Also, when you say that it sounds like you're trying to like greet me, not like in the hot sexual kind of way. I mean like animal-like way. It sounds like you're talking about me as though I'm some type of subhuman. I'm just used to dilute, you know, give you the good traits from black people. But you know what? I can't explain it. You know what I mean? That's not a compliment. You're implying that we're basically just good for getting you famous, getting you into sports, and that you have to be black in order to be good at these things, which is not true at all. It's not a compliment. I don't take it as a compliment. It's an ignorant statement. I honestly have a good sense of humor, and I personally enjoy race jokes, so I laugh at it, but it's ignorant, and I do correct it when I hear it. That is not the way it works, guys. Being black does not make you good at sports. Trust me, if it did, I would be a professional athlete too. I played tennis in high school, I played basketball, I played soccer, I did it all, and guess what? I'm not good enough to do any of those things professionally. I suck at them. So, that's that. Number 8, I always wanted to date an American girl. This is another ignorant comment that seems innocent under the surface. I'm an American, I should be happy, oh they love my country, which they do in any positive way, but when you look at the reason why they love it, it really all comes down to the fact that they think that you're a whore. They expect you to get them a green card. They think that you're going to give them this fun time and teach them perfect English and this, that, and the other. And basically, they also want to check off their bucket list, fuck an American girl, or I dated an American girl. And oh, I dated a black American girl and I have to find a white one, so type thing. I'm not trying to be a part of your bucket list. I do not want to be friends with or date people that are using me. And that seems to be something that they don't understand. But yes, people will openly say this to you. Oh, I've always wanted to date an American girl. I've always wanted to do whatever. And not in a good way. I mean like in a fetishizing type way. Where they're only doing this so that they can have the experience. They have no interest in going any further with you. That's not really a compliment. Imagine if you were to do that in the US. And you said, oh, I've always wanted to date an Asian. Like, not date as in like, marry you, bring you home to mom. But I just want to fuck you and tell my friends, hey, I had some tight Asian pussy. That's basically what you just said to me. That's not a compliment. And again, because these people are Japanese, they've been around themselves all their lives, they don't understand what it's like to be a minority, nor do they understand how offensive those comments are. They're just speaking their mind, and they're like, hey, I've always wanted to be an Asian, and an Asian, an American girl, because from their perspective, that's what they see on TV, and porn, and movies, etc. Just like how in the US, what we see in those things are Asians being sexy, whatever you want to call it. So, it just kills me so much. I hate hearing that now because I know why they're really saying it. But the good thing is when people are ignorant enough to say it, you know, red flag. Don't want to hang out with this person. Don't want to be friends with them. Not going to date them seriously. Goodbye. Makes things easy for you. Number 9. I like foreign women, or in the reverse, I like foreign men because they like to have sex. And specifically as a black person, I get the, oh, I like black women because they have good bodies. Or for my Asian friends that have made ignorant comments, I have always wanted to meet a black guy because I want to try their dick, or I heard they have really big dicks, or even other ignorant statements. I had a friend, you guys, she was actually Chinese, this isn't about Japan, but just throwing this in here too. She was dating black guys, but she was saying, she told me, I don't know whether she really did this or not, she would not have sex with them because she was afraid it was going to stretch her pussy out. I could not believe it, you guys. Like, we're not friends for lots of reasons, and this is definitely one of them. The amount of ignorance. I had to school this girl so much. I didn't even know how to feel about that, because one part of me was happy, because, okay, she's dating black guys. She's open to any race. But it's like, at the same time, you're leading these guys on, and your reason for not having sex with them is beyond stupid. That's not the way that it works. But I'm not going to get into that. I'm like getting angry just thinking about it. But yes, again, above the surface, oh, they're saying that I have a good body because I'm black. Well, I already know that. But at the same time, the reason for saying that is based on stereotypes. People that haven't even seen my body before, like just solely on just a profile picture, will tell me that they like black women because they can twerk or they have fat asses and things like that. And I talked about that in my, you know, video about Asian men, black women before. But yes, this is not a compliment. It's based off of a fetish. These type people are not type people that you want to date seriously. Because they don't really like you, they like your race, which that sounds like a good thing, but it's not. Anyone of your race will do. They have this idea, an image in their mind of what a black woman is supposed to be like. they want you to have a fat ass and big breasts, etc., which I do have those things. But you get what I'm saying? They don't like me. They like my body. They like what they think my body is going to do for them. That is not a good thing. We have the same problem in the US with people, you know, fetishizing Asian women, the whole yellow fever thing. People don't give a crap about Asian women. They don't care if you're Chinese, Korean, Vietnamese, whatever, as long as you look Asian, you look like the little hentai girls or whatever, you will do. They don't care how ugly your face is. You're hot simply because you're Asian. Well, it goes the same way for these guys. They don't care what your face looks like. Because you have large breasts, because you have a big butt, it satisfies their fetish, their idea of what a black woman is supposed to be like. That is their dream come true. They just want to fuck you. That's not a compliment. And on top of that, it's also always said in a really weird, creepy way, oh, I really like foreign girls' bodies. I like foreign women because they like to have sex. You mean because you're too cheap to afford to pay an actual sex worker for, you know, an hour or two, you figure you're gonna get free sex from me that you can't score in bed with a Japanese girl because they wouldn't like your ugly ass, but it's much easier to win over a foreign woman because our beauty standards are more realistic in that sense, where we don't want everyone to look the exact cookie cutter, same way like how it is in Asia. I mean, they're so detailed and what's considered as attractive, not only your complexion, but God, I mean, your face, the size of your face. So it's just like so many like weird things that they have that we don't have in the US. What I consider as attractive in Asia is ugly, and what they consider as attractive, what they consider as attractive is not necessarily ugly, but kind of weird looking, I would say, in the US. Whereas for what I personally like in Asia, my friends think it's like, ew, you like that guy? He's not cute. He's average. He's ugly looking. But again, that's different culture. We see things differently. We don't have the same opinions, almost considered as beautiful and ugly. But if you are a Japanese person that believes that, you're going to be in for a surprise, because not all foreign women like to have sex. And I wouldn't even say that most of them do. Do they have sex more often than Japanese girls? Yeah, maybe. I don't know. But at the same time, it's a stereotype and it's ignorant for that to be your only reason to date or want to marry one. It's childish and silly, and if you're a dumb foreign girl, you might see this, oh, it's a compliment, yeah, I'm better than Japanese girls. But really, at the end of the day, it's an insult, because this guy basically only likes you because he believes that you're an easy whore and that you're gonna fuck him 10 times a day, and he thinks he can't get that from a Japanese girl. I don't see that as a compliment. It's a backhanded one, for sure. And last but not least, number 10, the most controversial one that made this white guy angry in my comments on another video. I want to be friends with you I want to date you, or I want to be friends with you so I can learn English. A lot of people don't understand that people do not like to be used for some reason. In Japan, people will openly come up to you and tell you, I want to be your friend, I want to date you so I can learn English quickly. I teach English professionally and I get paid for it. Not only do you want me to teach you English for free, you just told me that you want to use me to learn English, to advance and get ahead in your life. And I'm supposed to be okay with that? Who want to be friends with or date somebody that just said that? Like, this doesn't even cross their minds. To them, it's like, oh, it'll be a fair trade. I'll teach you Japanese. And by that, they mean they'll teach you two words in Japanese, and you'll spend 90% of your time speaking in English. Not to mention that they decided these rules on their own. They told you, I want to learn English, and you're going to hang out with me and teach me. You're going to fuck me too, so... Nobody likes to be used. Yes, of course, naturally, if you're dating a foreigner and their first language is English, or if that's your common language, yes, you are going to improve your English ability, naturally. But the fact that you're openly saying that is, well, ignorant. Same thing goes for dating a black woman. Sure, any guy that's dating me is obviously going to see that I have a big butt and I have large breasts and I'm a curvy woman, etc. I cannot hide those things. I get it. But you know what I mean? Like, there's some things that should just be unwritten, unspoken. You just don't say and admit. One part of me is like, oh, at least you're being honest, upfront, whatever. And I do appreciate that, because it tells me, okay, stay away from this freak. But at the same time, it's like, how do they not realize this is not a compliment? It's ignorant. Imagine if in the US, I said in college, I want to hang out with you guys. You guys, you know, the little Asian bubble group that every college has. Because I know if I hang out with you guys, I'm going to succeed. I'll be really smart. I'll get good grades. I'm going to sit with you guys. Now, if you're dumb, maybe you'll be like, oh, wow, our first foreign friend. But if you have a brain, you'll be like, Did this black bitch just say that she wants to sit with us so that she can pass her classes? She thinks that she's gonna just cheat off of all of our hard work? I'm also implying that they're smart and that they're gonna get good grades because of their race. That's what you just did to me. That's that. Again, these are backhanded compliments that people give you. They mean well. This is not meant to be insulting. They think that they're being, you know, helpful to you, that they're gonna benefit you some type of way. They wanna make you feel good. And they're just bluntly being honest with you. But at the same time, these things are, well, insults. They're not entirely compliments because they're rooted in ignorance. They're rooted in racism, things that aren't necessarily so positive. The list can go on. I'm sure there's more things that I missed. If you have something that you would like to add to this list, give me your own list of 10 backhanded compliments or 5, however many that comes to mind that you've heard in Japan. Whether you're white, black, Asian, whatever you happen to be, what are some things that you have heard? Did I enlighten you? Maybe you are a white or an Asian person and you said some of these things, didn't even realize it was insulting. Give me your 2 cents. I want to know your opinion in the comments below. And as always, thank you so much for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, I would appreciate it if you would give me a like. And if you would leave a comment down below. Also, don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel if you have not already. And you can also follow me on my social media pages. I have an Instagram, a Twitter account, a Facebook, and a Snapchat as well. I would greatly appreciate it if you would follow and like those pages too. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye.